The Archdiocese of New Orleans is hosting a men's conference on March 7th at St. Catherine of Siena in Metairie, Louisiana from 8 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. With the help of David Warren and a bunch of the guys, they put together a great promotional video that we've been running on WLAE, and you can also see it on YouTube, Facebook, and the website NOLACatholicMen.com. Take a look now.
There is a voice that calls to you when you dream of happiness. When you can't sleep at night. When you compromise, sell out, and give up. When you are lulled into a life of comfort and mediocrity. When nothing satisfies you. It gnaws at your soul and tells you what you already know. That you were made for more.
Welcome back. The video really touches on so much of what we've been talking about. So many of us have looked to too many things to satisfy us. We've let too many distractions take our attention, and we have fallen asleep in our faith and have found ourselves overworked, overloaded, and empty. But in that hunger, there is this rise, this challenge to overcome, and in the fight, there is this reminder, men, have you forgotten you were made for greatness? Gentlemen, so we're back into the throes. You've been putting on this conference. Tell us, what is the hope? What are you trying to accomplish from putting on this conference? David.
You know, there are a number of conferences, and these days, going to a conference or watching a great video, it helps for a few days, yeah. Right? But it tends to, the effects tend to die pretty quickly.
Yeah.
But what we're doing here, we decided with a team of folks, Danny was a huge help with this, we decided that we're going to put on a big conference and put a lot of energy and resources into it. But then the conference is going to focus on what does this look like and actually changing your behavior and mm-hmm. making some progress, you know, real deal, you know, progress where the rubber meets the road at home when no one's watching in your parishes. And that's going to require continued formation. That's going to require some accountability and companionship. Otherwise, we're going to forget. Nobody's watching. Nobody cares. I don't feel like failing, so I'm just not even going to start, you know.
Yeah.
So what this is going to focus on is that the mission is possible. That's the theme.
Yeah.
The mission of actually doing something is possible. What does it feel like? What does it look like? You got 1,100 guys around you that are all feeling the same way, and they're all wanting to do something,
yeah.
Right? That makes a big difference. So the conference is going to provide the experience of this is real, you're not alone, and God can do real stuff. And people are going to experience the presence of God there. They're going to hear men talk about this in detail. But then we're going to be, the conference is going to be constantly focusing them on getting involved with a small men's group at their parish, mm-hmm. which sounds, you know, initially scary and a little ridiculous
yeah.
to most of us, right?
Right.
But the conference, I think, is going to help us get over the hump to say this is necessary, it's real, and here's what it looks like, and here's what it doesn't look like, right? For continuing to, you know, at least once a month, but sometimes even more, getting together with other men, talking about what's working and what's not, and figuring this thing out so we can actually make some progress.
Coach, you've been talking about this for years with men's conferences, part of the aspect of strengthening men. What do you see the importance of this?
I'm telling you right now, I'm fired up. If you're going to come to this thing thinking you're just going to sit there, this is going to be challenging. And the three speakers that we have are coming up from the wall, man. They're coming after in a good way, a loving way, but challenging. Men have to be challenged. I think the church has done a poor job of challenging. We have to back guys up. Yeah. Now, let's ask yourself some questions.
That's right.
And give some answers, not to us, to the Lord.
That's right.
This is what we're going to do. It's not easy to be Catholic. Mm-hmm. This is what it's going to require. Like Dave says, follow up. We're talking about action. Words, the Lord's tired of words. Yeah. He wants action. What are you going to do Monday? Back to usual?
Yeah.
No, small groups. But we have to touch men's hearts. Mm-hmm. When I had to have my heart touched. Yeah. I was walking down the wrong trail.
Yeah.
Another man brought me, Danny, you're way off base, boy.
Yeah.
You need to get back. And he showed me the path. Now, I had to say, I could have said no or yes. When they come to the conference, it's either, are you going to stand up? God's calling you.
That's right.
He's calling right now.
That's right.
Now, what's your answer? Yes or no? If it's yes, be prepared. It's not a shot, just walk in and walk out deal.
Right.
It's a long haul. It takes a long haul.
Yeah. This conference is going to be stacked. Y'all got an amazing group of speakers coming in.
Oh, yeah.
And tell us about the speakers, and also, too, tell us, what do you want? I mean, obviously, you want seats. You want people
butts
in the seats.
Butts
in the chairs, right? We want people there, but you want people to tap others and say, come to this, right? So tell us about the speakers first.
I think the speakers, I'm very familiar with both Peter Herbeck and Curtis Martin. Curtis is on college campuses. His ministries all over the world have grown tremendously. Strong Catholic, 9 kids, a great father, a tough guy, tough in his faith. We don't need ultimate fighting tough. We need tough guys. Yeah. Peter Herbeck's been doing evangelization for years, a renewal ministry. They go all over the world preaching. He's going to come with strong message, a caring message, what it's going to take.
Yep.
And then Joe Lombardi, I had a chance to meet him. You know, I met his grandfather, that's how old I am. here's a guy in a profession.
Yeah.
He's not afraid. He stands up and talks about his faith. He talks about Jesus Christ. He said, not the big guy upstairs. We're not talking about big guy upstairs. We're talking about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
That's what we're talking about. Yeah. So these are the kind of guys that are going to be delivering the message.
Now, Joe Lombardi's a last-second audible, pun intended.
Yes.
We had somebody else, right? But we had Jack Del Rio, who all the promotional material is for. But he just got hired by the Washington Redskins for the offensive corner. So. Blessings to him and his new venture. We'll miss him in New Orleans, but we're happy certainly to have
Joe. Joe will do a great job, I'm telling you. It doesn't matter whose name it is. It's going to be the message. I'm telling you, you guys are going to be excited. You'll be fired up. These guys are coming in here with, you'll see how they walk the walk.
So we're pumped up about the conference. It's going to be a day-long event, going to be a big rah-rah, punch guys in the face, get guys motivated. Let's
Can't
do this.
Punched.
It's part of... I don't know. I'm going to say something inappropriate, but it's just awesome, right? It's part of being a guy. Yeah. So we're all going to get excited about this. But David, you were saying that like the intention for this plan isn't just about the rah-rah conference, but there is a vision, a 3-year vision. I think Danny, you've said this also, of what this will look like. And so there is some direction, which I think is awesome, because sometimes you go on these conferences and it's like, yeah, awesome. Now what do I do, right? There's no direction after that. You guys already talked about the men's groups. Now, I want to ask a question here about the groups and what the vision for the groups are. I know we're tapping into the men's groups already that are established in the churches. But it seems like in Catholic churches today, there's like 3 types of men's groups. There's the social group that only gets together to drink beer and cook burgers. There's the service group that it comes together to fundraise and to cook for the parish events, which are fine. I'm not knocking either one of those, that's fine. But then there's also the spiritual groups that are guys coming together to pray together. But it seems like the 3 arms are all good in their own right, but each of them are distinct kind of silos that don't quite work together. Like, is there a vision of trying to encourage groups to be a little bit of all 3, where they can be a service group and a spiritual group and a social group? Or how are we kind of envisioning that happening here in the Archdiocese?
You know, I think that's a reflection of the 3 different types of guys you've got. You know, you've got the guys who are, my kids are in the school. I tend to be an extrovert. I like getting out of the house and hanging and drinking beer with other guys. So I'll go to the dad's group and we'll do that. Or I'm an overachiever, not really sure about the Jesus thing, but I can cook, I can do what needs to be done for the school to make sure they got money that they need. Or I'm the spiritual guy, you know, kind of like the wizard, you know, and I understand how to pray the rosary. I grew up with this, I've got some value there. And there's a small handful of guys, usually over 50, and those guys are praying hard, and they're the ones carrying the burden for the rest of us, right?
Right.
But I think what we're tapping into here is, and there's a few other categories that aren't even showing up, right? That's most of us, be honest. And I think what we're tapping into is the fact that, like, regardless of where we're at with this, regardless of how, you know, good we feel at spiritual stuff or fundraising or whatever, it doesn't matter, because when it comes down to it, what's happening when I'm at home in my underwear when no one's watching, like, that's where the rubber meets the road. Mm-hmm. And my participation at church is going to flow out from that,
right?
Regardless of who I am and regardless of what characteristics I've got. And so for these guys, I think ultimately these men's groups are meant to be, all right, what's going on at home? I'm going to take my home experience, my battle with even showing up to prayer when no one's watching, the fact that I don't believe scripture is something worth my time, the fact that I struggle to believe that God even hears me in prayer, I'm going to bring that experience, and we're going to flesh that out. We're going to take that, put it on the table, dissect it, look at it with a microscope. What do you see? What do you see? How's it going for you? You're like, that's the key. And those other things, I think, will flow out of that.
Yeah. I think another thing is, if you ask most guys around, hey, Danny, how's it going? Oh, it's going great. Yeah. Well, he's lying like hell. It's not going great.
Of course he is.
He lost a job. This is going on. See, the biggest thing I think we're lacking out here is, everyone's talking frivolous stuff. Yeah. What about LSU? What about this? What about the Saints? That's all great stuff.
Right.
What about accountability to one another?
Right.
Sharing with one another.
Yeah.
Jason, this is what's happening with me.
Yeah.
And Mary was over there saying,
yeah,
I can relate to that.
Yeah. That's
right. See, men hold it close to the vest.
Yeah.
Women bring it out quick. That's why you have to have separate groups.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because we're just different. Mm-hmm. We want to get men to feel comfortable. And accountability, confidentiality is the key in this thing. That it is manly to go to something like, it is good to share about a lot of times what's going on in your life. It's going to help you become, it's a conglomerative thing. It's, the personal touch of holiness. And then as you start walking down the path, you need other brothers in Christ, just like Jesus taught them.
Yeah.
And then what do you do? Send them out by two to start what?
That's right.
They didn't have a church, small groups. Yeah. That's what we want to do. If it was good enough for Jesus, it got to be good enough for us, right?
So tell me specifically, like, we want men to go, right? Mm-hmm. But more than just like you're saying, I want those who are listening, invite husbands, you come, fathers come, wives, if you're watching, get your husband to come. But we're asking men, too, to go around and tap people.
Yes.
What's the importance of that? And you were just tapping into that, that was part of your journey.
Not only tap to tell them, hey, be at the conference. No, you bring them.
Yeah.
You sign up and you bring them.
Yeah.
Just like when I went to the AA the first time, someone brought me. Buzzy Gagne brought me. Mm. And I went there. He didn't tell me, because if he would have told me just show up, I wouldn't have showed up. They got to be brought
there.
Where
can people find more information about the conference?
So we've got a great website, NOLACatholicMen.com. NOLACatholicMen.com.
Sponsors, tickets are available there.
Absolutely. Tickets are available. We've already sold a bunch, you know, but we got plenty of spots. We held one at St. Catherine of Siena because it's big.
Yeah.
We want to pack it in. We want to get as many guys there as possible. If you'd like to sponsor it, we're going to have over 1,000 guys sitting in those pews. It's a good place to do it. But bring, like I said, like Danny was saying, we're not asking guys to just come by themselves.
Yeah.
I need to be able to, as guys, going by ourselves, we know it's not going to work. So we're going to go with guys that we trust, guys we're comfortable with. I'm going to go with my brother. Go with your dad. Go with your friends, your men's group if you got one, your golfing buddies.
And everyone knows, you know somebody you can bring, don't
sure.
you?
Yeah.
Sure. Each one of us here knows.
Yeah.
Let's
more
let's
fun to come
make a
pressure.
List and that's start right. asking. Guys.
And you know, another great thing is the Syrians under all the seminarians are going to be there
that's
with
amazing.
Us too. That's what's going to be tremendous.
That's our show for today. Be sure to follow us on Facebook, check us out on Instagram, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or learn more about the work of Faith and Marriage at faithandmarriage.org. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you all join us again next time. God bless everybody.